Through the rain, I stand here as a boy sits staring through the rain. His lost light, his lost morning.
Through the tears, his sister sits and waits in silence. Through her tears, his sister sits and waits in silence. Through the tears.
Wandsworth Prison. Monday, the 28th of January, 1953. 8:58 a.m. He is 19 years old. I'm not much older. He is waiting in the corner of his cell, looking out through barred windows. He can see the world outside. It's his last light. It's his last morning. He will live another day. He will see another dawn.
Family's waiting in the corner of a room. They will look outside the window. They will see the world outside. They curse the light. They curse the morning.
They can't bear another day or to see another dawning.
The family's waiting in the corner of a room. They will look outside the window. They will see the world outside. They curse the light.
They can't bear another day or to see another dawning.
The people waiting on the corner of a road, looking up at his window, they give one last shout, but no one listens, so nothing changes.
They will fight another day. They will fight to clear his name. Derek Bentley grew up during the Second World War. His sister Joan was killed by a German bomb and his brother Roger died in infancy. When Derek was 15, he got into trouble with the police for messing around in a garage. He spent 3 years at an approved school where it was discovered that he had below average intelligence and was practically illiterate.
Through the rain we stand here as a boy sits staring. Through the rain is a fire.
Although he was 19, he had the mental age of 11, the reading age of 4, and suffered from epilepsy. When Derek was eventually allowed home again, he found it hard to face people, so he decided to stay in his room, where he would be safe.